Now, scammers target us all, but they hone in hard on the more vulnerable populations like seniors. We have to help protect them. Fox 5 iTeam's Dana Pfau has the latest scam, and her message is for them and, of course, those that love them. Dana?
Exactly. So before you say, I wouldn't fall for this, this might not be about you. It might be about someone you love. So listen in. If I said to you, has anyone in your family had cancer? You would most likely say yes. And that's how this DNA test scam gets started. And it doesn't end until these scammers have walked away with your very personal information. Listen in as these seniors from Covington explain what happened to them.
He was going to apartment. Very persistent.
Retiree Charles Bell is a smart cookie.
You seem like a sharp fella.
I thought I was.
But he was up against a successful scam cutting a swath across the state that targets victims already on fixed incomes.
He had on scrubs. He had on name tag. Mm-hmm. He had everything like a professional has.
And according to Covington police, he was a pro, all right. Mr. Bell and others laid it all out in police reports that say someone came to their retirement community knocking on doors claiming to conduct home cancer screenings, had them swab their mouths for DNA, then asked for their Medicare insurance and Social Security card information.
They offer the test, but then they gather very sensitive information from the victims.
Captain Ken Malcolm of Covington Police says they can use this personal information to, one, fraudulently bill Medicaid or Medicare, and two, to steal their identities, to open credit cards or other accounts in their victims' names.
Did you show him the information?
Yes, I did.
Did he take a swab?
Yes, he did.
Did you ever hear from him again?
No, I haven't.
Ms. Wyatt says she's been a fraud victim before, so she was, of course, reluctant to open that door. But still, this man dressed the part, found a way in by using an old carnival trick. He asked Ms. Wyatt and the others, too, if they had anyone in the family who'd had cancer.
They'll ask them, hey, does anybody in your family, you know, have a history of cancer? Well, who doesn't?
I said, yes, my sister just passed. I said, my father passed the cancer, my brother passed the cancer.
And just like that, he got her. Now, while one man worked the community, the other sat in a vehicle waiting, just in case they needed to get out of there fast.
No, they weren't parking there. They were parking over here, which alerted one of the residents that there's maybe a scam, the fact that they wouldn't drive their vehicles onto the property.
Scams aren't new, but DNA testing scams are. Why? Well, an advocate for Georgia seniors says Medicare is starting to cover the cost of some of this genetic testing. So it's not that far-fetched that a medical professional would say, you need this. But there's the rub. You should talk to your doctor, not some door-to-door salesman just wandering through the neighborhood.
We want you to talk to your doctor about what's best for you. Maybe you're a good candidate, maybe you're not. Maybe it's something you want to go through with, maybe it's not. But your doctor, your personal care physician should have the good answers.
Sounds easy, but obviously the DNA test scam works. The bad guy looks the part, scares people, and pressures them into decisions they'd not normally make. So make a point, if this comes your way, to walk away.
Ask your doctor if this is right. And here's another reason to do that. According to our volunteer group, Call for Action, there have been some cases where companies have come to retirement homes by the invitation of management and then offer these DNA tests. What they do is have unscrupulous doctors who've never met the patients sign off on these tests. Again, tests that might not be a fit for you.
So what are they gaining then by doing this?
That's fraud. They're defrauding Medicaid and Medicare by issuing unneeded tests by doctors who don't even know the patient.
Mm.
So there's the identity theft, there's the government fraud. They're coming at you a whole lot of ways.
Yeah. You know, I like what you said too about how instead of looking at this and saying, I wouldn't fall for that, keep in mind, you know, you have aunts, you have parents, you have grandparents.
And a couple of these folks that I talked to had been scammed before. Mm-hmm. And thought they were equipped to manage another scam. The guy came dressed in the part.
Knew what he was doing.
Sure.
Yeah.
They're pros.
All
That's
right.
why they do that.
They're getting something out of it. Dana,
yeah.
Thank you so much. We sure appreciate it.